Thank you. Call.
Good afternoon. The clerk of the board received written notification that Commissioner Gilbert and Commissioner Monestine will be absent from today's meeting. Commissioner Garcia. Commissioner Regalado. Commissioner Regalado, Commissioner. Vice Chairwoman Higgins present.
How are you?
Huh?
How are you?
We didn't get a memo for her.
Okay, we're gonna wait.
Center the Garcia level.
Thank you.
Commissioner Regalado. Vice Chairwoman Higgins. Chairman Soto. Only three members present.
And we're here.
We also received written notification that Commissioner Garcia will also be absent from today's meeting.
Yes. Yes. So we're going to have Mr. Attorney. We have the directors here, and I like to hear, being summertime now, and the kids visiting the parks and so on and so forth, and the libraries, and the pools, and I like for them to, the directors, I'll be calling the directors to give a little explanation so the people watching the show and others, they know what we have available directly from the guys who own the show, the directors of the departments. I think it's important that the people get to know from the directors about what we have to offer. We have a lot to offer. And being summertime and so many kids out there, I believe that the families need to know what we have to offer, which is a lot, by the way. So you tell me which way we're going to go, Mr. Attorney. I can't hear you. Your microphone is not working.
Mr. Chair, we could have you could discuss issues and have the chairs have the directors present information. It's a publicly known sunshine meeting. There's no quorum, so the committee can take no action, but people come up and discuss issues and
yeah,
information.
Action matters. We won't take action matters. We'll just have the meeting. It's going to be a short meeting, but I believe that the people of Miami-Dade County, the taxpayers of Miami-Dade County, they deserve to hear from the directors of all the important things that we have going on at the moment. This is July, and we're in the middle of the summer, and as a parent, grandparent, and great-grandparent now, I think I know a thing or two about kids and about summertime and all of that. So, and this county has a lot to offer, and we pay for all of that. So we should know, and we have great managers and great directors and great departments, and I think people deserve that. So I wouldn't be doing my work, my job. By the way, I want to applaud to all these commissioners present here today. Commissioner Higgins, Vice Chair Commissioner Regalado. They're here, these two ladies, busy ladies, with me today. And the others, well, the others didn't come. They must have their reasons, but we're here. And I'm here to serve the people and to each his own, as they say. Okay, so Mr. Attorney, you let me know.
It's at your discretion, Mr. Chairman.
Well, let's go. So let's move it, Mr. Attorney. Let's have just like a regular committee.
You can call. My understanding is you want to call a director up from each of the departments to speak.
Well, I'd like to start with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Okay,
as well we do. So, and we let's have it formally. Ms. Vice Chair, please Pledge of Allegiance.
All right. Please place the flag. I pledge allegiance
to the flag, the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. So let's play ball, Mr. Attorney. So we move on. We'll give the people chance to approach the well if anyone wants to, right? A moment for listening to the people. Do we, right, Mr. Attorney?
You may do that if you'd like, but there's no need since no action is going to be taken at today's meeting because of the lack of quorum.
Since I see that there's a person there, and maybe more than one, we'll listen. Yes, why not? This is America, and this is democracy in action. So, anyone here wants to approach the world and give us your views with respect and in order? Thank you. Go ahead.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. My name is Gloria Romero Roses. My address is 808 Brickell Key Drive. I had signed up to speak on an agenda item as it pertained to the way our budget dollars are allocated to our park improvements. Given that you're not going to be speaking on the agenda, I'd like to ask a broader question, which is given that we have a 2023 operating budget that will be coming up, hopefully released in the end of the month-ish, I'd like to understand how this committee will be working with the departments to drill down on what makes up that budget and how advocates will be able to interact and or make recommendations for things to be considered.
In other words, what if I'm copying you, you want to know more about the budget of the parks and so on and so forth.
And specifically how for next year it's being allocated and how citizens could advocate for additional items.
And maybe you know or maybe you don't. In preparation for the budget, there's going to be budget hearings. There's going to be 6 budget hearings. And you are always welcome to go to all of 6 or one of those or whichever way you want to go. I don't have the dates and the places, but the county, if you stay in touch with the website and so on and so forth, and the department, they will tell you where to go and what you may do. So come by yourself or bring your friends and whatever you want to do.
So again, this committee will not necessarily be reviewing the budget as part of its committee business?
Not now, and I would say that, and again, the parks director is here and so on, but this is not the moment of the occasion, as we said before. But you're invited to go to all these big budget meetings and say whatever you want to say.
Thank you so much.
Clear? Okay. That's done. Finished. C'est fini. C'est magnifique. Mr. Attorney, so we keep on. We don't see anyone else here who wants to come and express his or her views. Moving right along, and we cannot tackle items that require action. We're going to move on, Mr. Attorney. So where do you want to go?
Senator, Mr. Chairman, this is Morris Copeland, Chief Community Service Officer from the Mayor's Office. We have our directors here today, as you stated, and Ray Baker is prepared to come up and give a brief presentation of some of the wonderful things they're doing in libraries at your approval.
Nicely, and I see Mr. Baker there approaching the well. Mr. Baker, welcome.
Hello,
tell
Mr.
us.
Soto and Commissioner.
All ears.
Good to see you again today.
Yes, sir.
Yes, as part of item 1F1, which is a non-action item on the agenda, I put together a presentation to give you kind of an update on some of the big things going on in our libraries.
Fantastic. Now, go ahead.
Sure, and I'll start with the, as you're well aware, our new Westchester Library Health and Wellness Information Center, which opened back on April 2nd. New state-of-the-art facility that we worked on, based on a resolution that you passed to really start to provide this kind of an amenity to really inform the public about different health, wellness, and other related issues going on throughout the community. And I think, as you've seen over the last several months that we've been open now, it's really going gangbusters in terms of nonprofits and other groups coming in and providing lectures and presentations to the public on health-related issues.
By the way, Mr. Baker, I understand that today at 4 o'clock there's going to be a very important presentation by the FIU Medical School on nutrition. So everyone is invited, everyone watching the show or anyone invited at 4 p.m. in this center that you're talking about.
Yes.
4 p.m. presentation by the FIU, Florida International University Medical School, by Dr. Mora on nutrition. Okay?
Yeah, and that's an excellent example, and other groups like University of Miami and Baptist Health, these are all groups that we're, you know, getting.
Nicholas and all the others, with, yes.
For different kind of presentations in this facility. You know, a lot of hard work by our library team. You know, we were named a finalist for the Institute of Museum and Library Services Gold Medal. This is the most prestigious award for libraries given throughout the country. Unfortunately, when you know, we first presented this on, you know, some of the agendas that have been deferred, you know, we did find out we didn't win, but we were happy to be named a finalist. It's a level we have not reached in about 20 years. So I think it's really indicative of the work that's being done throughout our library system and the level of professionalism that we have within our department. Same with the National Association of Counties. We've been very successful, and our team is doing a lot of great work in communicating the programs and events that we have throughout our facilities. We've won over 87 National Association of County Awards over the last 5 years. So lots of really great stuff being done throughout the department. And just in general, you remind everyone, you know, the library card provides all kinds of great benefits. And it's not something that you have to go to the library to pick up anymore. You can apply for a library card online, and it opens up all kinds of different products and services that I'm going to talk a little bit more about as we go through this. And just interestingly, you know, throughout the pandemic, you know, people were in many cases not wanting to go into a library or a public space. And having the ability for people to sign up for the library card and continue to have all kinds of services and content available from us was a real big help. I think in online content use, we went up by about 25% during the pandemic, and it continues to have a lot of people who are really using ebooks and e-audiobooks as opposed to our physical books as well now. So it's a great way to not have to hop in your car and go to the library. Over the last couple of years, we've been working really hard on getting our service and operating hours consistent throughout the library system. And that's come as a result, you know, only of our mayor, but also in this board, and continuing to allow for additional hours and days of service throughout our budget. It was really important to us that people know that most libraries close and open at the same time and are open on the same days of the week at all locations. And for the most part, all of our locations are now on a very similar schedule, with the exception of a couple of locations. And it's been a big help. It's also, you know, for a while we were closing at 6 o'clock at many locations. We're now open at 8 o'clock at almost every site. And that's really opened up the ability to do a lot more in the way of events and other presentations and larger scale events. Talked about some of the summer activities. In addition to our summer reading program, which is really going gangbusters this summer, we do have available for the adults, Adult Learning Academy. It's an opportunity for people to have a curriculum of classes and things like Spanish, English, or even GED help, and in some cases citizenship classes. And these are available online, and we try to make it to where people can go through a very step and level increase in terms of what they're learning in these classes. Our homework help and tutoring program, another great opportunity to help with the summer slide. We're doing both online and virtual tutoring now. We help about 1,000 kids a week get free online free tutoring from the library. So it's a great way for families that may not have access to a private tutor or the ability to spend money on something like that, that we have certified teachers who are, you know, library tutors providing services to these students. And as you can see up there, we've already provided 35,000 almost tutoring sessions during this fiscal year. Many of you and many of your events, we always have the Technobus or our library bookmobiles. Our kind of traveling billboards and service providers throughout the county. We make sure that they're present as, you know, really at events that you're having, at events that other groups throughout the county are having. And it's a way for people to also have access to services where we may not have a library location. So mobile services, also another big part of our service delivery model. One of the things that we launched throughout the pandemic was our drive-up Wi-Fi. Also kind of pointing to people being concerned about going into public places during the pandemic. We have, working with our information technology department, who is outstanding, by the way, as you all know, we have now created about 956 drive-up locations throughout our libraries, with essentially in parking stalls where Wi-Fi is accessible from your car. So if you're concerned about going in, if you just need internet access, you can pull into most of our libraries and get access to Wi-Fi. I talked a little bit about online platforms. These are other great money-saving opportunities for you if you don't want to come and check out a physical book or to have a physical New York Times or Wall Street Journal subscription. We do provide these free with your library card. So things like New York Times, Wall Street Journal, Consumer Reports. We also have access to the Miami Herald in different formats, and other services like online ebooks and e-audiobooks, which also are things that you might pay for through other services but are free with your library card. So these are great ways to save money in a very difficult economic environment that we're in right now. Another service that we launched during the pandemic was home delivery. We are now, you know, anyone can request to have a book delivered to their home. And we're doing about 1,000 items a week that people are utilizing. So it initially started off as a service mainly for people who were homebound and unable to get out of the house. But during the pandemic, we wanted to make this available to everyone, and we've expanded it, and it's picking up use every week. Also, throughout the pandemic, there was many different grant programs available, from CARES Act to the ECF Emergency Connectivity Fund, which was made available to schools and libraries. We've been checking out mobile devices that are internet connected, ranging from Wi-Fi hotspots to tablets to Chromebooks. So someone can come in, take these home with them, and voila, they have a device and an internet connection in their house. And it's something that we can also work with many of your offices on, trying to promote that more as well. And another big initiative that we've worked closely with on the mayor and with other departments.
Ray, could I interrupt on the internet connectivity? How is the checking out of these devices going? Are you seeing a lot of demand for this? And how long does a person get to check one out for?
Sure. So with Wi-Fi hotspots, which are the little devices that you know what those are, as well as tablets, those are going gangbusters in terms of people love those and they're hardly in stock. The Chromebooks have moved a little slower, so I'm not quite sure why people haven't wanted the Chromebooks, other than people already might have devices, so there's not as much demand for those. So with your library card, you check it out. It's an initial 30 days, but if there's others in stock, people can keep renewing them until someone else is waiting for the device. So our goal is, of course, to let people hold on to it as long as they can. Working closely with the mayor's office and other departments, a big part of a librarian's job is often as an unofficial social worker. And we do a lot of different things, from helping people with their affordable housing, SNAP benefits, people who need shelter. And we've worked closely with, with Vicky's group. I'm just struggling for the name right now. But many groups that we're working with on connecting the different ways that social services are provided throughout our departments. And we currently have 2 social workers on staff. And one of our proposals for next year's budget is to add an additional 2 social workers to really start getting out to additional branches throughout the county. So, and that's what I had.
Fantastic, Mr. Baker. I think you do a tremendous job there. Things are going well, as far as I know. People are happy. Your libraries are very, very well attended by, and I'm a witness to that. by older folks, younger folks, mothers with young children, younger families. So I think you're doing your work, and we're trying to do our work too. So congratulations, and keep up the good work, and we'll keep working with you and always keeping you alert on anything we see or hear, or you know that. Sometimes I bother these folks at strange hours of the day or the week or the night for the good of the order. So, you know, it's for the good of the order. I'm here to do my job and try to do it well. And so I expect everyone to do the same. Thank you very much, Mr. Baker.
You are a
gentleman and a real good public servant. Mr. Attorney, we keep on going with the directors. I see that they're in the just warming up the one and only Mr. Spring, Michael Spring, the one and only. Michael and I have been around many, many years from the Tallahassee days when Michael was going around with his little bag going around the hallways, and I said, who's that guy? Oh, that guy's from Miami, and that guy's in all the culture things, and he's the man who knows, and the man knows. Believe me, he knows his things, his marbles, and he's a marvelous guy, too. So, Mr. Michael Spring, sir, you got the floor, say, sir.
Thank you, Senator, Commissioners. And speaking of the state legislature and the governor this year approved the largest budget for the arts in the history of the state of Florida, a little more than $59 million, which represents virtually full funding of the arts budget this year.
Hallelujah.
So,
hallelujah.
Big victory in Tallahassee. So,
thank you, Governor.
And thank you for much. All of your leadership, Senator, while you were in
thank
Tallahassee
you.
As
thank
well. And I'd like to note that while our department is dedicated to changing people's lives and neighborhoods through the wonder of the arts, this doesn't happen just in our department. Our library department has amazing arts programs that take place in library branches. And our parks department is one of the great collaborators we have in delivering arts programs in neighborhoods all throughout the county. And they have things like the Deering Estate and Zoo Miami that are some of the best examples of organizations dealing with arts, culture, and history.
Amen.
In the world. And so they're really great partners in this work that we have on providing opportunities to people of all backgrounds and means to enjoy the arts. I'd just like to mention a few quick things this afternoon. One is I'm just getting ready to send all of you a note about a workshop that we're having a week from today, a free workshop for anyone interested in getting a cultural grant. It's all being done by Zoom. And if you would be good enough to spread the word to your constituents, that would be great. So it's Thursday, July the 21st at 2:00 in the afternoon. This afternoon, I'll send you an email directly with the information about how to RSVP. And this is all part of our interest in making sure that everybody has the opportunity to get support for the work that they're doing. Speaking of going back to the Parks Department for a minute, Senator Soto knows that we have the new Westchester Cultural Arts Center out in Tropical Park at the entrance of Tropical Park on Bird Road. And we also have an amazing outdoor performance park that we're calling the East Park, where outdoor activities can happen in the arts. And that's directly next to the Westchester Cultural Arts Center. And earlier this week, we inaugurated the East Park with an informal concert, a free concert in the park that was
well
attended.
Michael, Tropical Park has become sort of our Central Park in New York.
It is. You know, it's a great hub for all kinds of activities.
And all of that. Thanks to you, and thanks for all the people working, Maria Nardi.
Absolutely.
And all your folks. Thank you very much, Michael. Thank you for all you do. Keep on going. We want to listen to you.
Yeah, just a couple of more quick things. The end of this week, we're going to do our kickoff meeting with our design team for the work that has to happen at Miami-Dade County Auditorium. The auditorium continues to be, you know, one of the great places to experience the performing arts in our community. And we're committed to making sure that the auditorium gets improved and can serve the community for another 100 years. But just this month, on Sunday of this week, we have the International Children's Festival, which is a free festival for kids at Miami-Dade County Auditorium that takes place between 2 o'clock and 6 p.m. in the afternoon. And so the auditorium is hosting the International Hispanic Theater Festival all of this month, and that's one of the big events for the International Hispanic Theater Festival. And then I'd like to close with just promoting two opportunities that our department offers. We have our Golden Ticket Arts Guide, which provides free tickets to senior citizens ages 62 and above, and that's available through our department and online. And we have our Culture Shock Miami program that provides $5 tickets to almost everything in town in the arts to high school and college students ages 13 to 22. And these are great ways to get an introduction to the arts at either no cost or a very affordable cost. And again, I'd like to thank all of you and the mayor for your support for the arts in our community. We have one of the most diverse and dynamic arts communities in the world today. Thank you.
Michael, thank you very much. Thank you very much for all you do. I'm always saying we really don't know what we have. In our town, we complain a lot for different reasons. Sometimes I think it's a matter of people getting too excited about things. Sometimes it's a matter of friends, I'm not criticizing anything or anybody, but I'm saying that sometimes we don't know what we have, and we complain about anything, the weather, you know, the this, that, or the other. We have some problems in the community, no doubt about that. Any big community, especially multilingual, multi-racial community like ours, composed mainly by political refugees, like in my case, people who came here looking for democracy and freedom, and we are always very excitable about things that may happen in other places, in other countries, with other things, and sometimes we don't appreciate what we have. We have one of the best places in the world, without any doubt, and regardless, and it's because of good persons like you and Maria and Mr. Baker, Maria Nardi, who take care of these big departments, important departments that are so close to the lives of the families of our community, because we need more art and culture. We need more parks. We need more programs in the parks. We need the people to go to libraries to read. I remember when there was somebody here in our midst who wanted to do away with the books, and I said, "What? Are you crazy or what? We need books and books and more books. Yeah, we need computers, we need books, and we need to read, right? Remember that? We had very big fights about that. Thanks God we prevail, and I love books. You know, let the people have books, and computers are okay, but computers are tools. If you don't read, if you don't love books, you're in trouble, man. You're in trouble, and there are books for anybody and anything. So thank you very much, Michael. Thank you. Maria Nardi, the one and only director of parks. Maria, take it from there.
Thank you, Commissioner, and good afternoon. Maria Nardi, parks director. I'd like to share with everyone that in July, we celebrate Parks Month. This is something that we celebrate throughout the nation, and it's an opportunity to celebrate really all of the park professionals that make a concerted effort to and are very committed to work on your behalf for this community through parks, transforming the communities, but also transforming people's lives every single day. So for Miami-Dade Parks, thank you, Commissioner. Thank you, Senator, for your leadership
in this committee as a park champion that you have been for all of your years serving as commissioner, and all the other commissioners as well. Thank you so much for your support. As we all learned through the pandemic, parks are an integral part of infrastructure in the community, and we couldn't have seen the proof of concept more clear than during the many hats that we had to wear when people wanted to be outside, and the only place to do that was really in parks and public spaces. So we thank you for your support, and to all park professionals, we salute them for their incredible work, working as food distribution in Miami-Dade parks, for mass food distribution to vaccine and testing sites, and providing opportunities for recreation and play throughout the pandemic. So thank you for that opportunity. Miami-Dade parks, you are really leading through your policy work and through the support of Mayor Daniela Levin-Cava, an incredible park system. We are the third largest accredited park system in the nation. And we are really seen to us through the work that my amazing team does as leading the nation in the holistic systems thinking about building a sustainable community through parks. And we look forward to exploring that even further and implementing those goals with all the different departments in the county. For us as well, this year we celebrate 93 years of Miami-Dade County Parks, so that's very exciting. Miami-Dade Parks began in 1929, and it began with the donation of Matheson Hammock Park, which established the conservation, the ethic of conservation and preservation. And then we have the other bookend, which is Reynolds Park, which was a site, a rock quarry, that was transformed into one of the most beautiful and amazing parks in our system. So we have the ethic of conservation and preservation on one end, and the other bookend, we have the ability for a park to transform an entire site from a brownfield into something spectacular. And we do everything in between, so it really is extraordinary. This summer, we have a lot of different programs going on, commissioners, and you will be happy to know that many of our programs are maxed out, and we look to hiring more people to serve the community through parks. For our community of residents that are watching this now, I would like to request that they go to ParkLink, Miami-Dade Parks, park.com, to register for multiple activities that we have through our entire system. We have something for everyone, from learn to swim to campgrounds, tennis, eco-adventure, camping, biking, our summer camps, and facility rentals. We talked about these central parks, Commissioner, you brought up in our community. Tropical Park is definitely one of them. And it has an extraordinary history and heritage that goes back many years back to really being a critical part of horse races and established equestrian, world-renowned equestrian center there. So this is something that we have programming there, and we have just extraordinary facilities in that park. A little bit more specific about some of our other summer programs, we have summer campers to participate in the second annual American Ballers Miami Basketball Clinic that is at Gould's at the Demps Park, recently renamed Demps Park. In this summer. We also have, we had July 8th, Miami-Dade County Parks Bike 305 that was established to bring greater education and awareness of bike safety to the community. And we hosted the Twilight Bike and Ride at Key Biscayne there. We also have recently ribbon cutting that we had the pleasure to do the ribbon cutting with Commissioner Regalado at Sable Chase, our nature-based playground, part of our initiative in addressing climate change and reintroducing kids to nature through play. So these playgrounds are filled with landscape, butterfly gardens, and play elements, the traditional play elements that they get to integrate with. At Tropical Park, we have the Marlins Youth Academy. from July 11th to July 15th, and then from July 18th through the 22nd. In partnership with the Marlins, we built and renovated 4 new baseball fields, and we are also providing extraordinary programs for our kids to enjoy them. It's my pleasure to also share with you that July 26th, we are having the Great Park Summit. The Great Park Summit was initiated and established by the Miami-Dade Parks as a way to engaging the community about the role of parks in transforming the community and people's lives. We haven't had one since COVID. We have one every 2 years, and July 26th, we are bringing it back. It's a virtual summit, and we welcome everyone to join in. July 30th, Miami-Dade Parks will hold their annual Summer Day of Service during National Park and Recreation Month, as I mentioned. So we welcome everyone to enjoy that as well. One of the things that we also at our zoo, we recently did the ribbon cutting for our first sea turtle hospital. Zoo Miami, our Miami-Dade Parks, Zoo Miami, as you all know, it leads the nation in one of the top zoos in the country. We have extraordinary new leadership
Maria, excuse
there.
Me, we still have the Pelican place over north, in the
yes.
north part of the county.
Yes, we do. We do. The Pelican Rehabilitation
a little bit because
Center.
I was there once, and I thought it was a great thing to have.
Yep.
People can go and see pelicans who have been in trouble, and they work with them, and then they finally release them. They yes. cure them and release them.
We do.
Being a marine a city that Miami-Dade County is, I think we need to be very much involved with all of it.
Absolutely. Great. They are our partners in at Pelican Marina and Park and Marina. They are definitely there. We are in turtle season, as everyone know. I know Commissioner Higgins knows that intimately well. Much of that is in her district in Miami Beach, as it is with Commissioner Regalado and also Commissioner Heyman. The Sea Turtle Hospital is very exciting, and also with Zoo Miami, we look forward to many other improvements in there. Just one of the things that we'd like to share with everyone, it is, of course, extremely hot out there, and we encourage everyone to take all precautions to protect themselves from the heat. And once again, we welcome everyone to join our programs. Come out in parks, and thank you, Commissioner, for this opportunity to share this with you.
Maria, since the committee meetings precisely have been designed, this is governed by committees, by the way, my dear friends watching the program and so on, people don't realize the importance, colleagues and others, they don't fully appreciate the importance of the committee meetings. Committee meetings, and again, this is governed by committees. This government works with the commissioners and with the committee meetings. And the committee meetings give the people the moment, the opportunity to be in front of commissioners and talk at length. It's not like the BCC meetings in which they don't have the chance to express their views or to participate as we participate with the people who come here for these committee meetings. That is important of the community. This, again, the government of Miami-Dade County is a government by committees in which commissioners handle the things with the people, with the population, and the mayor's another division. It's another thing. The mayor's the manager. The mayor's is the mayor. She's the man or women, they conduct the things with the administration of the place. We want to thank Mayor Cava, by the way, for all the good things that she does, and she's very good, I think, in participating with the Board of County Commissioners. But the Board of County Commissioners is a government by the Board of County Commissioners. And the Board of County Commissioners works precisely with the committees. So that's the importance of the committees. And we need to be in the committees and participate with the people in the committees. That's it. It's plain and simple, just like that. That's the way this thing works. It's the Board of County Commissioners. And it works like so. That's the reason for the committees, and there's committees about anything here. Committees about the airport, the port, the police, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And then there's committee about culture and recreation, and which is parks and museums and libraries and so on and so forth. And that's precisely what we do in this committee. So that's the importance of this committee. Very important committee, because we deal with the lives of these families. You know, families need parks, families need libraries, families need museums. Families are families, you know, kids of different ages, boys and girls, and that's the future of the country and the future of the world. That's it, you know, that's where we are. So we're dealing with one of the most important parts of this society, the culture and recreation of these families. Because families are the future of this country and the future of the world. So we don't appreciate that. Now we don't know what we're talking about. So, period. So I thank you, all of you, for participating. Maria and I have been working, always working on different things, but we've been working for some time now with the idea of smaller parks. And we have big parks. We have some wonderful big parks, the big Hialeah Park, the Tropical Park, the other parks in the south, the parks, and more parks, Madison Hall, this and that. We got bigger parks. But we need smaller parks in neighborhoods. Parks where, like in other cities, especially in Europe and other big and places of the neighborhood, you could walk to a park and have a little park near your home. You don't need to get in the car. You just walk to the park, 2-3 blocks, you're in the park. We need to have, I know that we have a lot of parks. We have 275 parks, I think, Maria, something like that, right? 280. So we have lots of parks in Miami, but we need more. We need smaller parks. And we have spaces in different areas. Maria and I have been dealing with that. We have some spaces that we can use and we can adapt simply so that people can go to the neighborhood parks. Neighborhood parks. We need to reinforce that. They don't have to be fancy. They don't need to be providing all kinds of things so that the people. They just need a place with maybe some benches, some trees, some shade where people can go and talk to each other and maybe look at the moon and the stars. And people need to get out of their apartments and out of the houses. They may be having a rough time with a. Women need to be away sometimes, right? And guys too. Well,
and Senator, so just on the idea of small parks, I just want to thank Maria Nardi and her team. District 5 is pretty chock-a-block with apartment buildings, but underneath the way that the team has designed such a great project for the underline, her team is now looking at the spots underneath the Metro Mover. So they pretty much finished or getting really close to finish a new little dog park in downtown and then a children's playground so that all of that space isn't just wasted space, but it's activated space and becomes useful green space rather than empty space. And Ray and Michael and Maria, it looks like summer is your busy season. I guess everybody's happy I see a lot of heads nodding. I guess you'll take a break when those kids go back to school. But just want to say thank you for all your work. And I'm glad, Senator, we got to hear from everyone about what's happening this summer because our community is a better place because of your work. Because you do the things that bring it to life, right? It's not just the drudgery of getting to work on the transit committee and all of that and the building of the roads, but you make this a really nice and enjoyable place to live, and particularly on behalf of District 5, the cultural institutions, the parks, the turtle team that wakes up at sunrise, goes and takes care of our turtles. It really is special to have all of you. So thank you very much for your words today. And to you and all your teams, we appreciate everything that you do.
Thank you. Thank you. Commissioner Regalado, I don't see her here now, but if you're around, you're invited to say or express your comments on different items here in the committee. Thank you. Anything else, Mr. Attorney? Anything else? The items, the action items, we're going to move them to the committee on the 19th, I understand, right?
Is there anything that needs to be moved earlier? I see some heads nodding in the back. Are we able to just move it to July 19th, to the next commission meeting?
I think we need to move, Mr. Attorney. What's
that request can be made through your office, Mr. Chairman, to the chairman's office.
Okay, so we don't need to do that here now. Okay, without anything else back there? Do we have anything else from the departments present here? No. We're okay. So thank you very much, commissioners. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And we move on. Thank you.
Good day. To me.
Bye. Thank you.